Okay, this question is from my Instagram reel and it currently has over 1 million views. So let's see what the question is. We have a triangle and notice this is not a right triangle. And we are given that this area here is 28 and this side here is 6. And we also know that this right here is 4. And the question is asking us to find out this area here. So how do we do it? I will show you guys the fast way first and I'll show you guys the proof after that. So let's have a look. Whenever we have this situation, right, a triangle, you cut into like two parts. As long as you know the area and then the side, and then one missing area and then the side, you can set up a proportion. This is all you have to do. I can put 28 over 6, right, area divided by its corresponding side here, and then make that equal to, here we have the question mark, divided by its corresponding side, which is 4. And now we can just solve for this equation. To do so, multiply both sides by 4. So that this and that cancel. Reduce this by 2 first. 2 times 50, that's the answer. 2 times 28 is 56. So you can see that question mark is equal to 56 over 3. And that's it. That's it. All right, now here's the proof. So here we go. Whenever you have a triangle, right, it doesn't really have to be a right triangle, so let me just do something like this. Go ahead, draw a segment connecting from one vertex to the other side like this. I'm going to call this side right here little a, this side right here little b, and then this area capital A, this capital A, B. Now, I'm going to first show you guys that, or I will claim A over A, it's equal to b over b. And that's exactly what we used earlier. Now, how do we do it? Here's the deal. Let's go ahead and just find the area for this triangle first. We have the base that's little a already, but the area of a triangle, we also need the height, right? So let's just focus on this real quick. To get the area of this red triangle, for the height, I will have to start with this vertex here and then drop a perpendicular line. So it's like this. And then I will have to extend this right here, right? And then make sure it's perpendicular. I'm going to call the height h. Now, for the area A, that's just going to be base, which is little a, times the height, which is h, and divided by 2. So we have ah over 2. Okay? And in the meantime, we can also do the same thing for capital B. This right here is its base. And then to get the height, well, we actually have to do the same thing. Extend this side, go up, and then it's the same height. So for capital B, base times height divided by 2. Now, as you can see, both the equations, they share the same h. So if we can solve for h, and then we can just set them equal to each other. So right here, I'm just going to multiply 2 on both sides and divide a to both sides. So h is equal to 2a over little a. And then right here, when I do that, we'll multiply 2 to the other side, divide little b to the other side, like this. This is h, that's h, they have to equal to each other. Therefore, you see, 2 capital A over little a has to be 2 capital B over little b. Both sides have a constant multiple 2, right? So we can cancel it out. And technically, you can say multiply both sides by 1 half. So that this and that cancel, this and that cancel. And there we have it. Capital A over little a is equal to capital B over little b, which is what we are trying to show. Sorry, I forgot this is a proof, so I should have put a little box right here and shade it in. Now we are done.